EFF have written a letter concerning water outage, right? There is a problem. There is going to be a problem of 6 months without water. So without further ado, let's jump right into it. EFF released a statement on the upcoming 6 month water outage Tuesday, 17 September 2024. Economic Freedom Fighter EFF note with outrage the impending 6 months water outage affecting municipalities in the Free State and surrounding region due to the scheduled maintenance of Lesotho Highlands Water Project LHWP tunnel. The maintenance starting October 1st and lasting until March 31st, while necessary, will leave many communities without steady water supply. Yo, I thought it's good for me to talk about this. EFF continues to say, in response to Minister of Water and Sanitation, Penny Majordina has called on all affected municipalities to expedite plans to ensure continued water provisions. These interventions include upgrading water treatment works and raw water pumps, contracting new reservoirs, and developing groundwater resources through boreholes to improve water access and supply during the shutdown. While these projects are crucial, the EFF is concerned about the readiness of many municipalities, as this is tall order in such a short space of time. I want to concur with the EFF. What the municipality or what this the minister is doing here is just to say, you know what, but I told you, you know. But I want to say that to people who are going to experience this, I thought to myself, you know what? I think it is prudent of me to do the to talk about this, and to I think it was prudent of me to go deeper and make you understand the situation at hand, so you can prepare. We are about to have water shedding, right? So let me prepare you in advance. So I'm not going to waste much of your time in this episode. I'm going to just jump straight and read this thing. The other paragraph says, this begs the question, how can we be facing such a dire water crisis when budgets have been allocated year after year for maintenance and creation of new water infrastructure? The government have refused to prepare adequately despite years of warnings. Their orchestrated sabotage will punish the poor, leaving millions without access to basic water service. Is the EFF lying or telling you the truth? But wait, I want you to tell me in the comment section below. Is the EFF lying or not? Wait, speaking about lying or not, am I lying when I say do this? If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people, because to subscribe it is free, to like the video it is free, to comment in the comment section below it is free of charge, to click the notification bell it is free of charge, to share this video it is free of charge, to watch this video until the end it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge, and that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contributing to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel, and you know what I'm saying, we'll bring you more. And also, guys, want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed. Okay, as we proceed, let's proceed with the letter. It continues to say, the shutdown will result in staggering shortfall of 80 million cubic of water, meters of water at the time when the summer heat exacerbate the need of water. The Minister Majordina can call for quick fixes. The minister Machodina, can call for quick fixes, but this is merely a band-aid solution to a problem the ANC has created. You see, this is very interesting, the point that the EFF they are raising here, to say we are in summer, and how do you then expect people to look, because people are gonna be in need of water. How do you then expect people to survive in this situation? The timing of this thing is just something else. But let's proceed as well. They continue to say this. Gauteng water supply also rely heavily on the Lesotho Highlands, with critical resources such as the Skatkoen Dam, which supplies the Vaal Dam, drawing directly from Lesotho Highlands. Rain water, the body responsible for water supply to various municipalities, is now struggling to meet growing demands in these regions. When the EFF look over the Department of Water and Sanitation in the city of Ekurhuleni, despite noting this orchestrated neglect of water infrastructure, we worked to reduce non-revenue water losses to below 30% and consistently achieve no drop status. However, we will still find ourselves with empty reservoir due to this dependency on another country. Come on, EFF. Come on, EFF. Come on. Will you blame do you blame the EFF when they say this is something that the ANC has planned? The ANC. The letter continued to read as follows. Despite drawing less than our licensed water allocation, we face shortages due to insufficient bulk water supply from rainwater. Under the EFF government, the city of Ekurhuleni has constructed new reservoir water towers to boost storage, but this infrastructure remains dry due to the lack of bulk water supply. This is a clear sign of the ANC's failure to invest in alternative water resources and innovative solution to source South Africans' most essential water. They say, South Africans' water supply system is already on the brink, with nearly half of all systems posing severe health risk due to contamination. Over the two-thirds of wastewater treatment works are failing, and 47% of clean treated water is lost through leaks or mismanagement. Shockingly, 67% of staff in water treatment plants lack formal training, rendering these critical infrastructure even more vulnerable. Okay? IEFF is an IO. But what I can tell you that reading this, somehow I can tell you that the EFF is using this to score a point, political point. I wouldn't blame them. I would do so too. Right? I think now you can do so. So, the next one says, the outrage exposes the ANC's deliberate negligence and sabotage of our water system over the years. This ongoing mismanagement, lack of care, and refusal to upgrade our water infrastructure reveal a sinister agenda. The ANC's ultimate plan to privatize water supply, mirroring their disastrous handling of state-owned and local entities such as Eskom, Transnet, South African Post Office, SAA, they are now gunning for one of our most basic human access to water. The very institution tasked with finding solution to South Africans' water shortage, the Water Research Commission, WRS, has already been infiltrated by foreign interest. The Gates Foundation has pumped over $1.4 million into the WRC, embedding itself into our water system without any rightful stake in the basic human needs for our people. This foreign influence now steers the WRC towards private partnership and profit-driven business solution, prioritizing corporate greed over the people's right to water. EFF, my daughter. This outage is a national emergency, need to be treated as such. Access to water is a basic human right, and any failure to safeguard this right during this tunnel shutdown will be seen as a grave injustice to our people. The government needs to act swiftly and effectively to minimize the impact of local communities, particularly the most vulnerable, who are disproportionately affected by service disruption. The last statement says, the EFF will remain vigilant throughout the period and will hold both local and national authorities accountable to ensure that the necessary measures are taken to avoid water crisis in the affected region. I thought the most important thing that I wanted to do was to bring this awareness that, hey guys, there's going to be water shading. I don't know what is happening. What is happening here? Hebatung.